Thank you. Yeah. Austin, Texas. Mr. Brian Louie. And our monitor man tightening drums. I don't know where he's from, but that's Wayne. Miami. He's from Miami. Get for that. And on drums, pounding quite profusely from St. Louis, Missouri, Mr.
And on lead vocals from Notre Dame, Indiana, Rick Florian.
This is severely screwed up. Yeah? Okay. Point number one. Okay, when you're living in a world severely screwed up, they have a tendency to not care about God. And for those of us that are trying to live our lives in obedience to Him, sometimes we don't get a lot of encouragement from the world. But you know what? When you are living in obedience to the one that gave you the very breath of life, you can know beyond the shadow of a doubt that you're His desert rose.
Thank you.
love playing the guitar. I gotta tell you why though.
Yeah!
Because I feel God's pleasure when I play. That's right. The Lord God Almighty gave me a gift. And I use that gift to glorify Him. And that goes for every man on this stage that you see up here. So don't go putting us up on a pedestal. Don't go glorifying us. We're just like you. We love Jesus Christ. We pray that you see through us and you see Jesus in us. And nothing else, folks. Just Jesus Christ. Because we realize at some point, God made it clear to us that there's a call on our life. So we decided to answer that call. There's a call in your life tonight, people. All you need to do is answer that call. a lot of times we wonder that, like, when I talk about this calling we have in our life, it's like, man, it can get really complicated. What does God want me to do? Where do I need to go? What school do I go to? Do I go to school? Do I get married? When? To whom? All of those wonderful questions that take years and years to answer. If you are confused, you can know this. Beyond a shadow of a doubt, He's called every single one of us in this room to a love calling. Every one of us.
Shine.
So this is the first night, huh? We're real excited to be able to be a part of this week. We really hope your week is going to be a great one and that you can find a lot of great things and hear a lot of great things. There's some great artists this week. Right now, we're going to go back a few years. How many of you how many of you have been with us for more than 4 years or have been familiar with our stuff? Well, we sure appreciate your support and your ministry. We're going to right now go back a few years. A lot of times we get some requests, so we're going to do a few of our favorites, and hopefully they'll be yours. If you want to sing along and worship with us, just feel free. But just worship God right now with us.
States, please answer. Fortnite, Indiana, brought the plan. Let's get this out of the way right now. Go Bulls.
They rock.
You ready to have a great week here this week? I tell you, the things like this, the people that you meet here, they're going to be your friends for a very long time. And we all need times like this. You know what? We need this just as much as you do. Because when the people of God come together, you start finding out that you're not all alone in the world. And that the things of God do matter to a whole lot of people around the world. You start getting strong. People, we need to be strong. This is a crazy world. It's estimated by the year 2010 there'll be at least 22 nations in the world with nuclear weapons. Nations without constitutions. Nations without any checks and balances to keep the egos of Saddam Hussein's world back in their easy chairs. We got holes torn in the sky above Antarctica. We got people we can't feed. We got a whole lot of broken families here in America. 55% of all the households in America are married, but about 25% of those are single. Single parents. Some of you know what that's about. Because you felt the ache of somebody missing in your life. The message of the world says we got a long way to go. But the message of Jesus Christ says, I have given you hope, but not your faith. He says, I've come to give you abundant life. You're going to have about 60 million questions in the next 4 years, I promise you. I went to college. I know it's hard to believe. I got a degree. It's really hard to believe.
No way!
Okay, it was eighth grade, but...
In what?
Music education, and there are people all over the world eternally grateful that I never used that degree. Clarinet players in Indiana, real happy I never used that degree.
You know, you may do some crazy things in the next few years, maybe some things you're not so proud of. I hope not.
You're going to have a lot of questions, because you can't have the answers handed to you by your parents or your youth leaders.
Oh, listen to what they say. Take those things like treasures and come back to them, because they're not given in bad faith. You're going to have to test your own life. But I want you to know, even when it's dark, there's somebody looking out over heaven, but just you. And when you think the meaning is down, believe with all your heart, like it says in His Word, I will lift up my eyes into the hills. If you happen to go here to school, you can do just that. God doesn't need losers. He needs believers. And if you're a believer, you'll know that you are His child. If you're His child, you are an heir to His very throne. You wonder what the future of America is? I wish you could stand up here because I'm looking at it. You want to know what the future of your church is? Your community? Man, you just need to stand up here a while. Don't feel the burden of that. Feel the hope of it. You can change the world in which you live if you believe with all your heart and all your soul that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. This week, ask yourself some questions. Do you really believe that? I'm not talking about just a good time hour. Think about the great point, being about 07. You still believe it? Maybe you go to a secular school and your roommate's doing a lot of dope and you're in a big, whole lot of trouble. Just having him in the room, you gotta believe it then. When there's people down the hall drinking all night long and you know that they're giving away their soul to something anybody can buy over any counter, anywhere in the world, you gotta be strong. When your somebody's going to you, hey man, it's just a little joint. Hey man, I have seen thousands of joints. I was playing in bars when I was 15. Ooh, that was exciting. I see more wasted people than you ever want to see in the world, and let me tell you straight off the top, there is no glory in that. Losing your mind, wow, that's exciting. Jesus says you must lose your life to find it. This week, look at your life. See what you found. If you're walking alone, you'll know. He doesn't want you to walk alone. That's not why he came here. That's not why he died. But it's certainly not why he rose. It comes down to this. We all have to say that he is our strength. He is our power. He is our hope. And he will lift you up to do the hard things that this world is going to require on you. You just got to lay it down.
priesthood of the holy nation. We need the people of God being strong, standing shoulder to shoulder, side by side, brothers and sisters, raising up the heart of their belief, looking into the heavens, and knowing that the cross of Jesus stands at the crossroads of time. We need to come together to believe like never before and come to the powerhouse.
this excitement outside these doors and share with somebody who doesn't know him, all right? Thanks for coming out tonight. Thanks for being fun, too. God bless you.
One time, I was coming out of here from Haight-Ashbury, and my car broke down. I had to get here in a hurry.